Anybody there? Open up.
What's the fuss? The bathhouse is closed.
Need to talk to the owner. I know he's here.
I'm not sure that matters, as he's terribly busy.
Tell him Geralt of Rivia wants to talk to him.
I cannot promise, Mr. Reuven, that we'll have time to see him.
Want a bed?
Very well, I shall try. Please wait.
Siggy Reuven cordially invites you to join him. I'm happy. The meeting is in the baths. We will pass through the dressing room so you can leave your clothes.
Let's go.
You may disrobe here. Your equipment will be safe. Splendid! Siggy Reuven awaits in the next room.
Hi, Whitehead. Nice
one, you have. You were right. He doesn't blush.
I do. Coffee's out. I'm ready to shut up the corpse's arms. And then you sent the body
Love
back.
Lovely, Reuven. He's home like a horse.
Clear that you've not seen Reuven.
Gudrun calls it Erberus.
Yes.
Does it look back on itself?
Lovely. Yes.
Easy, Cleaver.
Orsan Junior's a dead man. I'll have my scribe send you a notice.
You don't have a scribe. And we'll eliminate Junior when, and only when, all of us say aye.
Reuven, your guest.
Why the fuck you let him in here? Because I want to talk to him. This is Geralt of Rivia.
Good to see you again.
As always, I'm out of the swiving loop. Who the fuck are you?
I'm a witcher.
Problems with your plumbing?
Nah, it's under control. Geralt's a friend from the old days. Although...
Got intruders. Someone just snuck inside the bathhouse. Several men.
What the fuck's he on about? Plowing fortune teller?
Assassins!
Bloody hell. I fucking knew it.
Any weapons tucked away?
Just a few. First ever Barney with my prick hanging out. Ah!
Not one escapes. Got it.
God damn it. Take madness.
Good work, gents.
Terribly sorry for that incident. My security failed. I'll get to the bottom of who, why, and how.
They were whoreson scum. That's the bottom of who and how right there.
Don't start that again. Especially not in front of our guest.
Who pranced in right before they attacked. Coincidence? Why do I doubt it?
Let's give him a chance to explain.
I'm looking for Horson Jr.
Interesting. What do you want with him?
Junior's gonna help me find someone.
Horson's not helped a soul in all his miserable life.
I'll ask him nicely.
See, Cleaver? Perhaps if you'd not called Junior an uncle fucker and asked him nicely, he'd have showed up today.
Gentlemen, you out of your fucking minds? A chat session? Horson's out to get us, and he'll succeed, eventually. We've got to kill him first. So by all means, you sit here, soak, fart, and watch the bubbles rise, while I send my boys to Horson's hidey holes. They'll make some noise, flush the bugger out. And you, Geriatric, or whatever your ploughing name is, wanna find Horson? Find me first.
Any clue on Junior's whereabouts? Be grateful for any lead.
Siggy? It's worth a try. Geralt's got a knack for finding people. And he's discreet, a value in itself.
Leave you to it, then.
I'll, look in on you tomorrow, Francis. Finish our talk.
So how about we get dressed?
Sure, sure. Then we'll talk. In private. Right mess that was. Never thought I'd be glad to see the man responsible for my taking frequent baths.
If you're any cleaner for it, gotta say it was worth breaking your ankle.
It healed poorly. Can you believe it? I must soak it in hot water at least 6 times a day now. Failing that, it bloody pounds like the bells of Beauclair at dawn.
I had my reasons. Your leg would be fine if you hadn't gotten in my way.
I see. Well, I promise you that if I could go back in time, I'd do things quite differently on Thanet. For example, I'd have my men kill you instead of just tying you up.
Listen, Reuven. No, Dijkstra. Just not in the mood for your code names, passwords, and other bullshit. I'm here on specific business. If you want to listen, listen. If not, I'd rather you spared me your wit and threw me out now.
What's the harm? Talk.
You think Cleaver will find Horson?
He might. He might not. But he'll burn down half the city trying. What waste. Leave him to it, I say. Work alone.
Any ideas?
Junior's got areas of the city where he's strong. Penetrate them, look around. But be discreet. None of this speed and fury and swinging your steel cock about.
Makes sense to ask around, I guess. Junior might be in hiding, but he's got to be collecting income. Couldn't afford to cut himself off.
Gambling, that's his big earner. Junior controls the largest casino in town. I'll never forget. Hierarch Hemelfart raised all kinds of hallowed hell there once. Bugger bet, lost his ruby ring. Then there's the arena in the city's bowels. Betting scheme generates near as much as the casino. They're always looking for hired muscle there. Suppose you could always search Horson's house, though I doubt you'll find him there. Maybe some clue, though.
Where's Junior's casino?
Near the Temple Watch Towers. Horson's got nought to do with the casino officially, so careful what you say. Try not to arouse any suspicions.
Arena sounds promising. Where's that?
Sewers beneath Gildorf, but you'll have to enter through the bits. Endure the stench of poverty on the way. Now, Junior loves a good fight. Wager he'd give a lot to see a real Witcher in action.
Mentioned Horson's got a house. Where is it?
Solid townhouse on Temple Isle, just on the other side of the bridge. Wouldn't wager me knickers on finding him there. Junior's not that stupid.
See if I can't find Horson at the casino or the arena. Might talk to Cleaver as well, though.
Do what you will. Just be cautious. Horson's expecting payback, I've no doubt.
Thanks for your help, Dijkstra.
Just go, Witcher. And if you can't find the slimy bastard, come and see me. I know him well. Might figure something out.
Listen, Dandelion's missing. Any idea what might have happened to him?
Same thing that happens to anyone who steps on Junior's toes.
Meaning?
He's surrounded by splendid virgins who ply him with sparkling wine and pastries stuffed with nightingales' tongues. Come, Geralt, what do you think's happened to him? I reckon he's at the bottom of the Pontar, trussed up with the strings of his own mandolin.
Loot.
Far as I'm concerned, he might as well be rotting down there with a goddamn trombone.
You wouldn't happen to have a bone to pick with Dandelion, would you?
Course I do.
You serious?
Dead serious. Dandelion published a sonnet recently. Second stanza, the shit uses paired couplets instead of an inserted rhyme. Surely you understand how deeply offended the poetry lover in me was. The bastard shan't get away with it.
I was being serious.
As am I when I say I have exactly no time to worry about your gigolo boyfriend. Got me own problems. Problems you might be able to help me with. And if you did, why then I might be inclined to ask after Dandelion, establish what happened to him.
Maybe I can help. What do you need?
I'd rather show than tell. Picture's worth a thousand words and all that tribe. Ah, and you do realize, if you say anything about what you see here to anyone, it'll mean a razor between your ribs.
Figured as much.
Excellent. One last request. Oh, let's call it what it is. A command. Don't draw your sword unless I ask you to. So kind as to follow me. Oh, Bart! Bart, stop that! Now!
Bart! Man! Bart makes Ziggy lose, Jonathan!
Beating your head against the wall won't change that.
Bart hurt! Bart less thinky! Bart less thinky! Bart sadness!
Don't seem to have trouble communicating with the troll. Why'd you bring me down here?
Take note of that hole. We'll come back to it later. And see that door? Vault behind it, until recently filled with Novigrad crowns and countless other valuables.
But God! Then boom! Jorfut, go!
Translating into common, someone fucking made off with nearly 20 tons of my gold. And all the lighter stuff. And you will help me get it back.
Fine. I'll help you.
You're not exactly bursting with enthusiasm.
Witcher mutations. They strip us of emotion. I'd be jumping for joy otherwise. All right. Ought to look around. But first, some questions.
I'm all ears.
Take it the thieves got in through the hole behind you.
You're a regular fucking master sleuth. Any other brilliant deductions you want confirmed? The year, maybe? Bloody name of Redania's king?
No, but I am wondering, for instance, how that hole got there.
Hole no. Boom! Hole. Bat look won't go. Bat look no. Only sleep. Bad shoes, head falls.
Bad mushrooms? What's that about?
Pops mold. The spores are highly toxic. One whiff and you're dead. Unless you're a troll, that is.
Yes. Bad. Troll.
Not talking to you, dimwit. Where was I? Ah, mold spores. They cover the walls of the sewers other side of the vault. Actually thought it was a good thing, you know? A bit of extra protection. Thieves found a way through it.
Bart, you see them?
Bart through hole. Once see, boom, got what? Breathe, shroom. Sleep, go. Your fun gone. Bad troll.
Now, stiff up a lip.
Boom. Can you elaborate?
Boom. Big. This like.
I'll elaborate. Explosion. Big enough to blow that fucking hole in the wall, separating the vault from the sewers.
Gotten pretty good at communicating with this troll.
Lots of prior experience. Worked with idiots my whole life.
Try to track down the thief yourself?
Of course. Hired this lummox, Fonce. Thick enough not to ask questions. We knocked back some pops antidote and entered the sewers. Soon after, I returned alone.
What happened?
Lad started belching something horrendous. I mean, burps with so much mass the walls shook. Told him, Fonce, stop. You're in the presence of a count. Well, former count, but still. And then he puked up. Up came most of the antidote. Lost his protection. Tried to pull him out. Then I heard a bubbling. Something crawled out of the water. I value the lives of my men, I do. But I value my own even more. Dropped Fonce and ran like hell.
Should look around the sewers. Got any more of that Pops antidote?
Have a few vials left. Got the formula too. Disgusting swill, to be honest. But it'll save your life, here.
Thanks.
You've naught to thank me for, literally. You're no good to me if you suffocate. Listen, I'll be upstairs if you need me. Sight of this empty vault's giving me an ulcer. Good luck to you.
Dandelion, what the hell have you gotten yourself into? pipes, great. Explosion crumpled it like a piece of paper. And there's mortar on the bars. So it was in place at the time of the explosion. Blast tore it from the wall. Bits of pipe clear over here. Must have been one powerful blast. Shouldn't go any further without taking that antidote.
Getting harder to breathe. I thought Witcher's potions were vile.
Fine grating. Couldn't push much through that. Definitely came through here. Another trinket. The thug Dijkstra hired. Dijkstra didn't mention anyone else. Must be one of Dandelion's crew. Vomit everywhere. Guess he had the antidote too. Couldn't keep it down in the Shimmerhill corpses. Otherwise, the would stop congregating.
What now?
Bottom of a container. Silver cylinder, most likely. Runes etched in the bottom. It's warped, probably by the explosion. Bomb part. Must be. Smells like wyvern oil and caramel. Gold coin. Trail ends here. Dandelion must have loaded the treasure onto a boat.
Damn it, can't breathe. Gotta get out while I can.
Pipe's great. Explosion crumpled it like a piece of paper. And there's mortar on the bars.
So
edges curled out as at the time
something
of the explosion
blew it wide open.
Tore it from the wall, too. Bathhouse drain pipes seem to converge here. That'd be it down here. Time to see Dijkstra.
Got a minute?
I do. What do you want?
Done. Examined every nook of the sewers near your vault.
Well, learn anything?
Seems to me a bomb blew the wall open. Look.
Bottom of a silver cylinder, probably. Covered in runes. Interesting. Any idea what it contained?
Recognized some ingredients by their scent. Wyvern oil and sugar.
Sugar? Geralt, I'm in no mood for jests.
Nor am I. Just saying what I found. Bomb contained sugar.
Let's think. Sugar would react violently with sulfuric acid, but not so violently to cause an explosion.
Didn't know you were versed in alchemy.
Dabbled in it a bit while at Oxenford Academy. But this is no time to reminisce. You're to find my treasure, not write my biography. Know anything else about this bomb? Anything at all?
Bomb went off inside a drainage pipe embedded in the vault wall. But the grate at the end of the pipe was in place when the blast happened, meaning...
The bomb must have found its way into the pipe from inside the bathhouse.
Exactly. Might have gone something like this. Perpetrator started emptying one of the pools, then dropped the bomb down the drain.
The bomb flowed down with a runoff, came to rest on the grate, and, to quote Bart, big boom.
Drain pipes are only promising lead. We just need to know which pool it's connected to.
Yes. Appen keeps a record of guests. Should be able to tell us who used that pool the day of the break-in. You've not done badly.
Feel honored to be acknowledged.
Oh, that famous sarcasm. I missed it.
Really?
About as much as I'd miss a knife in my knickers. Alright. You inspect the pools on the right, I'll take the ones on the left. Holler if you find anything.
Nothing here. Something floating on the surface. Oil, looks like.
More cobwebs than a witch's den.
Silver lid. Matches the cylinder bottom I found in the sewer. Dijkstra, come here.
Got something?
Yeah, bomb part.
Happen, drain pool 4, and bring me the guest book. Chop, chop.
Let's see what's on the bottom. Grate's been removed from the drain, meaning they flushed the bomb down here.
Happen. Who used this pool the day of the break-in?
Let me see. Bertel Heitz, town councilman, Josef Schweik, brewer, and Margrave Henkel.
Henkel? That's impossible.
Margrave Henkel, who's that?
Who was that, you mean? Old Coot's been eating dirt since last winter. Couldn't have been here the day of the break-in.
He's dead. I'd not heard.
Not surprising. The Honourable Margrave croaked in a brothel, decked out in leather lingerie, so the family held a hush-hush funeral. But I have my sources.
Yeah, I saw him that fateful day, Mr. Reuven. I'm certain of it.
Did you speak to him? Get a good look at him?
No. He merely passed by on the way in.
So you didn't see Henkel. You saw an impersonator. Think for once. They scooped out your balls, not your brain. And you, Geralt, start looking into this.
Fine. Where should I start?
Henkel's home. Derelict townhouse south of the main square. You might happen on some trace of this scoundrel we're looking for there. Well, off with you.
Graves townhouse. Dandelion made some interesting friends. Here. It's absolutely excellent. Startling bouquet. You absolutely must try it. But afterwards, please place the bottle back where you found it. Your birth year. Dandelions. More series. Satisfying click. In the next room over, I think. Secret room. Probably where Dandelion and his cohorts planned the heist. Stain. Wyvern oil. Sugar. And lumps of a substance dipped in wyvern oil. Potassium? Looks like they made the bomb here. Instructions on how to build a bomb, signed by one Kalkstein. Ciri, Menge is following me. He has seized the treasure. He has Dandelion. You must flee. Footsteps. Not good.
We could use someone who knows a bit of magic. The runes on the bomb, I'm absolutely dying to know what they mean.
You dying to know too, Triss?
No, just here for the coin.
Ah, Marigold playing the cynical materialist. I love it. In truth, her ideals brought Triss here. She needs gold to save her colleagues. When I recover my treasure, I'll be in a position to help her. Simple as that. Speaking of which, and pardon my Beauchlairoise, have you found out who fucking nicked my gold?
Bothered Triss for nothing. No point examining the bomb.
Because?
Because I already know who nabbed your treasure. Commander of the Temple Guard, Caleb Menge.
Well, well, Marigold. Your coin stands to come with a side of revenge. Geralt, would you be kind enough to tell me what you've learned? I'm terribly curious.
Henkel told me. Old man's alive and well. Faked his own death to escape his creditors.
Strange. I had no idea he was in debt.
He was. And Menge promised to take care of things in exchange for help with the heist, so...
Geralt, how can I put this delicately? Bollocks. If you thought I'd fall for that tale you just pulled out of your arse, you don't know me one bit.
All right, I lied, but only partly.
Heard of beasts that are half lion, half eagle, maidens who are half fish, but you'll never convince me there's such a thing as a half-truth.
I'll give it a shot anyway. Didn't actually see Henkel, but Menge does have your treasure.
Take it you learned this by peering into a crystal ball.
Maybe. Trade secret.
You're hiding something. And that's one thing I can't stand. Even more than Nilfgaard. But ultimately, this is a business deal, not a marriage. Besides, there must be some truth in all those lies. You're too dense to make it all up on your own. Menge has been spending heaps of coin lately. Though to my knowledge, he shouldn't have a copper to his name.
So, what now?
From what I've heard, Menge spends his nights at the docks, Witch Hunter's quarters. Maybe pay him a visit. Ask where he's holding my gold for me.
Doubt Menge will admit anything willingly.
As do I. Lucky I hired a witcher and a sorceress who've been through so much together to get this done.
What's our past got to do with it?
A great deal. Lovers will jump into the abyss for one another. Suits my needs perfectly. Namely, it greatly increases your chances of getting out of the Hunter's Barracks alive. With my treasure.
In other words, you're using us.
Using you? Never. Merely making the most of your mutual bond. Well, lovebirds, I really must be going. Good luck.
Thought you'd correct him. Say that we, you know.
Dijkstra doesn't need to know about my love life.
Wise. I'd never choose his shoulder to cry on either. But we've strayed from our topic. Got a treasure to recover.
Triss, gotta tell you something. Dijkstra's gold, it's the last thing I care about.
Thought as much. This is about Ciri, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Menga's got Dandelion locked up somewhere, and Dandelion saw Ciri.
That changes everything. Listen. Meet me at midnight by the Chapel of the Eternal Fire, east of the harbor. We'll figure out a way to get into the Hunter's Barracks together.
All right. See you then. And thanks.
Do you like it?
Glad you're here. Listen, took a look at the building and it does not look good.
Mean it could use a bit of paint and spackle?
I mean, it's a damn fortress. High walls, guards at the gate, armed men everywhere. We could never sneak in, and fighting our way in won't work. Menga would have had plenty of time to escape.
What do you suggest?
Take these shackles. Put them on me.
Explaining what this is all about?
Think. Bring the hunters the vial Triss Marigold. They won't just open the gate for you. They're likely to let you present her to Menga personally.
No way. Too risky.
Dandelion's life's on the line. Ciri's too. No such thing as too risky.
Say they take the bait. What then? We go in, I put a sword to Menga's throat and ask him where Dandelion is?
Might not work. Menga's scum, but you have to admit, death doesn't scare him.
Always found that annoying in fanatics. So we gotta trick him into talking. Any ideas?
Maybe tell him you have information about the Lodge. Or about Philippa. Even better, he hates her most of all. You'll think of something.
Still got a bad feeling about this, but tough. Let's go.
Geralt, remember, I can take care of myself.
What are you talking about?
The hunters. They won't treat me like a lady, but I'll survive. Might hurt a bit, but... Ciri, she's what matters. Do what you need to do, no matter what happens.
Can't promise that.
I'm still asking you to, all right?
All right.
What do you want?
Here for my reward.
What the hell for?
For a witch. Recognize who I got? It's Triss Merigold.
Merigold? Come in then.
Well, well. Triss Merigold. Giving up drowners for sorceresses?
Pays better.
It's cause they do more harm. What's a drowner do? Pull the odd fisherman from his boat. But the witches, they murder kings, scheme, start wars.
Don't forget turning your cow's milk sour straight out of the udder.
You're done jesting, Merigold. For good. Put her in a cell.
Hands off.
What did you say?
Yeah, I sensed him. Knew we couldn't trust him. Witcher, witch, one and the same.
So they can burn at one and the same stake?
Scram before I lose my... Spread out!
Oh, shit!
Don't let him drive you back!
Of you.
Alive.
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 Ah.
all of them. That was close. I must say, trickery and deceit, not your strong suits.
True. I prefer straightforward solutions.
Yeah. Fight first, ask questions later. We should search the office. Maybe we can find some documents mentioning Dandelion. I'll search his body, you search the room. I'd start with the desk.
Find anything?
Just his office key in his pockets. Here. Nothing under his belt. Wait, something sewn in the lining.
What is it?
The key to a vault. Here, give it to Dijkstra with my regards.
I found a letter to Menga from someone important. A spy, I think.
A spy?
Take a look.
Drop boxes, secret signals. Yeah, strong stench of spycraft here. This agent could know more about Dandelion.
Bet he does. Letter explains how to signal for a meeting. No mention of where it would take place.
Maybe Dijkstra can help. He knows everything.
Everything? Slight exaggeration there.
I'm not so sure.
Key to a vault? No address? Why do I doubt this'll make Dijkstra smile?
Well, might keep him from setting his thugs on us. Breaking our legs for failing to fulfill our part of the bargain.
Meaning glass is half full?
Of something strong, I hope.
All right. Nothing left for us here. Let's go.
Be glad to. Just not by way of the main gate. This is where we split up. But first, let's burn this shack down.
Agreed. We've left too much evidence.
Yeah, but I also need to blow off some steam. Listen, there's one other thing I wanted to talk about. But not here, and definitely not now. Come by later when you have a moment. I'd appreciate it. All right. We need to get out of here.
That should do it. I'm going. You should too.
Mm-hmm. Not about to use the teleport, though. See you, Triss.
You there! Mr. Reuven wants a word!
Impatient old bastard.
What?
Nothing. Be there soon.
Who do I spy? Why, it's Geralt of Rivia.
Will you stop following me already?
I will! Soon as you tell me where my treasure is.
Me and Menger didn't see eye to eye.
How badly?
Badly.
I suppose that explains the smoke. My treasure's not in there, is it? Burning with the witch hunters.
Didn't see it anywhere, and 20 tons of gold is hard to miss.
You mean to say you've come to me empty-handed?
First off, you came to me. Second, I do have something in my hand. The key to a vault, founded on Menger.
A vault that I need to find on my own? You've not made things much easier for me. Give me that.
Spare me. I want my reward.
Geralt, do all you witches have such nerve?
What do you mean?
You lied to me. Again.
What?
You knew from the start who robbed me, but you didn't deign to share that information with me.
No, I didn't. But I did deign to help you find your treasure, so stop moaning.
I jest you not, Geralt. You abused my trust.
I can live with that.
This time, yes, you'll live. And now, time to settle things.
That a threat?
Quite the contrary. You helped me, Witcher. So in spite of everything, you've earned your reward. I take it you've still no idea what happened to Dandelion.
None. Found someone who might know, though. A spy, I guess. Signs his name, Yammerlack. Found a letter of his. Just one problem. It only details how to arrange a meeting with him. Makes no mention of where.
A ruined house in Far Corners. Give the signal, and he'll show up there the same day, just before midnight.
Thanks for your help.
No need to thank me. Just paying off a debt. I always do, you know. Even to liars. And a final humble plea. Don't try to fool me again. Ever.
Oh!
Oh! God, let even you into the city.
Drenched again.
Now you.
Mutants, blasphemers, kobolds.
Must be the drop box. Gave the signal. Spies should show up in Far Corners before midnight. To hide. Classic. Triss? How'd you know to... Dijkstra, huh?
None other. I couldn't resist. Really want to see this through to the end.
Perfect place for a tryst. With Triss.
Mm-hmm. Ceilings collapsed, mold on the walls, mouse droppings in the corner. Lips almost pucker on their own.
Shh. He's coming. Hide.
Menge.
Indisposed. Very indisposed.
But you're in deep. Shit right up to your nostrils.
You're in deeper, I assure you. But answer our questions and we'll help you get out.
The answer to each question will be the same. Sod off.
You'll talk. Just a matter of time. So save us some, yourself some too, and stop acting tough.
Or what?
Or I'll have to hurt you. Permanently.
I see you know your way around an interrogation. So do I. You're the bad one, all threats and torture. And the Red One's the good one, full of sympathy and sweet promises.
That's where you're wrong. Had enough?
Fuck off! I can take this.
Of course you can, but I'm just getting started. You must be thinking, this can't possibly hurt any worse. Oh, it can.
Enough!
So, gonna talk?
Yes! Just tell me what the fuck about!
We're looking for Dandelion. We know Menka captured him.
That's what this is all about. The fucking minstrel. The amount I've set up at the start. Before you bloody started mucking my mind with magic. I can't believe it. For a miserable sack like that.
Get to the point.
The Dandelion is on Temple Isle. In the dungeon beneath the shrine. Menga's planning to execute him in Oxenfurt. Positively spectacular.
Afraid you'll have to call off the show.
How can we free Dandelion?
Those who leave Temple Isle do so only on Menga's orders. Issued in person.
Damn it.
We'll find a way. I have an idea. Tell you later.
Where'd Menga hide Sigurdin's treasure?
I'm the clue.
You realize one word and you'll howl at me.
Yeah, and yet I still say I don't know a thing. Does that make you think?
Think he's telling the truth?
Ugh, looks like it.
Enough. We've learned everything we wanted to.
Glad to hear it. Can I assume we can put this unfortunate incident behind us?
Not so fast.
I know. He's seen too much.
Why? I told you. I'll never.
Either he dies, or I wipe his mind.
Strip him of his memory.
But I helped you. I helped.
It's not so bad. I promise.
Peace, lay, and give.
How do you feel?
Base? Cruel? Vile. I could go on. But I need to get out of here. Now. Go home. Bathe. Then drink myself to oblivion.
Said you had an idea about freeing Dandelion.
Yes. We know he's on the island, and he'll stay there until Menga orders him transferred to Oxenfurt, right?
Mm-hmm. Problem is, Menga's dead. So?
No one else knows that. He could have escaped the fire. He could reappear. Him or someone very, very similar.
A Doppler?
Mm-hmm. Your old friend Dudu Biberveld impersonated the halfling merchant. Dandelion claimed he seemed more real than the original. So much so, Vivaldi gave him a loan of several thousand crowns without batting an eye.
Yeah, except Dudu's in hiding right now. Priscilla might know something, though.
Fingers crossed. Listen, there's one other thing I wanted to talk about. But not here, and definitely not now. Come by later when you have a moment. I'd appreciate it. All right. We need to get out of here.
My wife's mum's an old sucker.
Lay me there with a barrel of beer and a cup.
The guards nabbed her. Started ripping out his nails.
Reuven takes a cut. Cleaver takes a cut. How's a man to turn
the tail? Ah!
You look familiar.
Geralt!
Dandelion, I know where he is.
Where?
Dungeons on Temple Isle.
That's not a nice jest.
No jest, sadly. But don't worry, we'll pull him out. Triss has an idea. All we gotta do is find Dudu.
So you must find Dudu in order to find Dandelion, with the aim of ultimately finding Ciri? Sounds like an awful lot of searching. But I do wish you luck.
Don't have a choice. I gotta meet a